Hey, this is Brimstone. You're watching AFK away from the keyboard. Ain't no better place to be than right here watching now.
I'm Miltos. I guess you know who I am. I played Syrio Forel in Game of Thrones. And I am being assisted by this amazing man. Would you like to introduce yourself, please?
All right. My name's DeCal, and I run a sword fighting club in Houston, a sword to sword. And we're working with Purple Heart to bring the wooden swords that you see here, the upgrade, as well as the basic training gear. Yeah. So these swords were used in the actual TV series, and originally the story goes that 4 years ago, Purple Heart got an order from Ireland for 6 days, and they were like, okay, well that's cool, we'll get them out in about 2 weeks. And 2 days later, they got a phone call. Wait, have you shipped our swords? You're calling from Ireland. We'll see what we can do. And so, and that was the last we heard of it for a year. And then we started getting phone calls and emails from past customers saying, "Did you guys know you guys are in the new HBO TV series?" And Christian and Tasha don't get out all that much on TV watching, so they're like, "What's this Game of Thrones business all about?" So there we are. When we found out from the con that Miltos was going to be teaching his sword dance class here, then I was like, "George, do a guy a favor, hook us up." Right. And so this morning we presented him with one of those premium swords with a quote from Syrio Forel, "The first sword of Braavos does not run."
And engraved just down the middle of the blade,
which on the floor.
And also, so he will be assisting in the sense that he'll be keeping an eye on you lot when I get you to kind of smack three shades of stuff out of each other. Would you like to introduce yourself to the group, please?
My name is Connie Point. I'm just one of the handlers here with some of the other celebrities, and Miltos and I got to talking one night, and I mentioned that I'd had some martial arts training, and
I was very drunk.
We were both a little tipsy.
But anyway, she's going to be looking after you as well, okay? So, I am here to basically do a kind of crash course in what I know about sword fighting, contextualizing it in two things: my experience on working with Game of Thrones and the sword fighting and the attitude to the sword fighting scenes in the series, and also comparing that to what it really is like to really fight with a sword. Comparing the elaborate choreography of actors showing off with a sword to the reality of the longer a fight goes on, the more chance that you will both end up dead, which is not a good outcome. So the idea is that the first blow is the last blow. Basic common sense. So, I have spent all day, I began the day doing one of these workshops. I'm sorry the room is quite small. There's quite a lot of you, which is fantastic. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically use some of you to demonstrate. I'm going to try and get everyone involved. And ultimately, at the end of the workshop, you're going to be in pairs. And you're going to be kind of improvising a little bit of a sword. It may be two or three moves, all right? But we're going to make it count, okay? So, yeah, you better believe it. So, what I would like to do, I would like to ask you to come into the space, and you please, sir. Into the space. Great. Yeah, come on. Seeing as you've dressed up. Yeah, okay. And you, and you, and you, and you, sir, and you. Okay, let's just begin with that. So, most of the time when I speak to actors, I always have to ask them to get into a circle. I didn't have to do it this time. But I'm not going to want you to be in a circle because you're kind of demonstrating for these lovely people. Right, all I want you to do is find a space in the room. And you just need to have enough room that you're not going to hit anyone. Try not to be too close to a wall. There's some space here.
She says she'll duck.
Come and stand here. Let's be a couple of steps forward. Right, okay. Basics. Remember to breathe. Who's holding their breath then? It's an amazing thing. You ask someone to stand still and they immediately stop breathing. It's beyond me, I don't understand it myself, but it just happens. So the most important thing, the first technique, is to remember to breathe. Calmness is the first thing you have to learn when it comes to using a sword. The more tense you are, the less fluid you'll be. The more tense you are, the quicker you probably will end up being sliced in half. So breathe. Then I want you to find your stance. Feet hip width apart, grounded, solid. I want you to keep your knees soft, which means that they're slightly bent, so you're almost sitting into what I like to always think of is like a pole, that you're sitting on a pole and it's sticking up your ass. And it's basically you can pivot on it, right? But it's grounded, and I will test this. Because I don't want you to be leaning on your sword. Your sword is not a walking stick. It is an extension of your arm. You need to be solid. I don't want to be able to push you over. Ground yourself. It's important to be rooted, and sometimes it's not about a wall. So, you're breathing, okay? Deep, slow, oxygenating your blood, waking up your brain. You're rooted, and I want you to think about it, not just do it, think that your feet are rooting into the floor. The most important thing is when you are fighting that you do not unbalance yourself, right? So, secondly, I want you to bring up your sword into a ready stance, a preparation to engage with your opponent, all right? I want you to do it with your eyes closed. Because I'm trying to show the group and each other what the instinct is. Because invariably it's about instinct. Okay? And then I just want you to open your eyes. Do not change your positioning. Keep doing what you're doing, but just open your eyes. Okay. Any comments? Who do you think? It's okay, do not worry, this is for us to judge you. No, not yet. We're here. It's going to be fun. I know it doesn't feel fun at the moment, but it will be. Any comments? Who do you... I'm asking the people against the wall. Who makes you go, yeah, this guy knows how to sword fight? Anyone? Or girl? I say guy, I mean both sexes. You can speak.
That guy over there.
Which guy over there? This guy? Do we have a consensus of agreement? No. Well, the indifference is overwhelming. Okay, I'll give you a hand, okay? What's very important is that you guard yourself, you defend your body, right? And a sword is designed usually of a certain length. Of course, we have different length swords, but this will protect you between your genitals here. Other people may have genitals in other places. But generally speaking, genitals here and the top of your head, right? You need to keep your elbow into your body. So, always remember that the sword is not something that you wave around like a wand, right? This is not Harry Potter. This is Game of Thrones. There's a difference. It's got to be strong, okay? It's got to defend your body, okay? You can see that. If it's out here, hit my sword. That's pathetic. That's it. See, you control my movement by doing that. But if it's here, do it now. Do it again. Do it again. So you keep it strong. Everything is rooted. It's an extension of your arm. And when you block or attack, you put your body into the move. It doesn't come out here. Because you're unbalancing yourself. Someone could chop your hand off. It's not clever, right? You're not reaching for your opponent. It requires a sense of fearlessness, all right? Do not go into a battle to fight someone with a sword unless you mean it, right? This is the other thing about choreography in shows. It's actors love to show off with this. You give any actor a stick, and they will pretend it's a sword, right? You can't stop them doing it. Even I did it on my first day. I was like, oh, great, I get to play a sword master. You mean I'm just going to be busting kick-ass moves all over the place? And then he went, no. No, that's not really what happens, is it? Not really. If you're a teacher, there is a reason you teach. I mean, it's like watching the only good thing about the new trilogy of Star Wars films is finally seeing tiny little Yoda completely be a badass and go, yes, that's exactly what the reason why he's Yoda. Thank God. That was the only good thing, am I right? Right. Yeah. So, as you can see, let us fight one-handed, seeing as we're going to do the Bravosa style, okay? So, your sword is out, prepared and defense at the same time. Ready to attack and also to defend yourself. Keep that elbow into your body, okay? We're going to play the sideward stance, which keeps the target smaller. We're going to do the Bravosi style, all right? Okay. Strong. So I can't, yeah, that's good. That's really good. Root yourself. Even bend your knees a little bit. Shake that ass. The thing about it is that you've got to be flexible and fluid, okay? Okay? I don't want you to be static. You're not going to be fighting and defending yourself just with a sword. I need you to move your body. You've got to be ready. Ready to move, okay? But still. Good. Okay, good. Good. Okay, so what I'm going to ask you to do is, I would like... each of these people to be partnered up. So from this group out here, just go and get yourself a partner. All right? Okay. Hey!
I need one
What's
more.
The matter? What's the matter with this lady? Okay. So, some demonstrations, all right? What I'm going to ask you to do, and I really, people, because there's so many people here, because you've got a small room, I really don't want you to hurt yourself. For example, this afternoon, I said this, and of course no one did hurt anyone else, except that I hurt someone. Right across the knuckles. They even bled. You know what? I was very apologetic. He was chuffed. He was really happy. He said he was going to post it on Facebook. It made his day. I don't get it. I don't understand it. But I'm just letting you know, injuries do happen. So I need you to focus, and I need you to not chat too much. I need you not to chat too much so that when I talk to you, just hear what I say. So, the people who've just joined, you've observed, you've seen what I've asked you to do, okay?
Wow.
That is so brilliant. A's are the people who joined their partners, all right? A's are the joiners. So all I want A to do is, with your stick, to touch your opponent. You have to let them touch you, because they're going to do it very gently, where you want to attack them. All right? What I would recommend is that there are major points. The arteries between the thighs here. The arteries underneath the arms here. Of course, in the neck here as well. And if you have a thrusting blade, the heart. Because you do not want to engage into a fight because you want to show off how good you are at fighting, okay? You want to kill them in one move. Japanese style. Yes?
Yes?
So, choose your point. Make it count. I want it to be a facial one. And all you need to do is just touch it. Touch that place with your stick. Touch it. Touch it.
10 seconds.
Gently. Okay? I want you to touch it and hold it there. Alright? I want you to focus on that point. Yeah, focus on it. Know where you want to attack. And then I want you to go back into the first stance. Preparation. Engage. Yeah? And I'm gonna go and all you're gonna do is touch that place. Ready? And. Okay, can you see what's happening here? I think you need now we're doing the touching, we need to put a little bit of energy behind it. So, for example, let me demonstrate. I'm going to go here, okay? We begin like this, right? I'm going to go for the neck. Now, I could do that, but I'm making myself very open like this, yeah? I'm overextending. And really to make contact, I'm going to have to get off balance. So I'm going to have to bring my body in as well. Even this is very bad. Ideally, I should go from here to here, right? So you're always, always grounded, because at any point they can do something, they can even kick your legs away, right? There's no such thing as fighting with honor. What's the famous line from Game of Thrones? No, not that one. God damn you.
You're winning or you die.
No.
You're winning or you die.
No. You did not fight with honor. No, but he did. The one who died. Right? Okay, there are no rules. It's all about living or dying. So, we're going to do that thing again. And I think you just need to step in. Be fearless. Step in. I'm not asking you to make that move like an attack, like you're going to really hurt them. I'm just going to say, you're just going to touch. Just going to touch. As efficiently as possible. Do not expend any energy more than you need to. So, first stance. This is not very good. This is a little bit open. A little bit stronger. Strong, strong, strong. Yeah? Okay, and. Go back. First stance. Ready? And. Go back. First stance. Ready? And. Good. Now, I want you to just do it again, and in that final place, I want you to see whether you feel you're going to, if someone came over to, well, I'm going to come over to you and push you over. So let's just go back. First stance. Ready? And. Stay there. Check yourself. Are you as strong as you can be? Are you? Sorry, that's wrong. almost, I would say you probably need to bring this leg in a little bit closer, bring it in even more. So you've got to move like that. You've got to move to that place. Okay? You need to bring your body. And everyone is different. Some people can move like little monkeys, other people are like antelopes. Yeah? If you're an antelope, you've got to move more. Okay, go back. First position. Ready? And. Good. Stay there. Now, what I want the other person to do is avoid that blade. So, I need you to parry or to block that blow. Now, that could be as simple as just stepping back with that leg going back. Anyway, you know, I'm teaching someone to suck it. Okay. So let us go back and let us do it one at a time. This couple here. So I think we're a little bit close to begin with. I don't think you should be crossing blades at all. This is already too. It's almost like you do not ever really begin like this. You always begin like. Also, this is the other thing, right? We can play that game all day long where you've got your sword sheathed, right? And it's like. The gunfight at the opening round. That's a lot of nonsense too. The only way you're going to win a fight is if this is out already. All right? And God forbid if you carry your swords like this. That is always a favourite in films. Two blades in the back like this. You know, let alone however long they are to get them out the back. The fact that you're opening yourself up completely to get them out is never going to really end well, is it? Right? So you're ready to fight, okay? So I want to see the first blow, the first move there. Good. All right. Already. Very good. But I would say you need to. Okay. Just go back. Just go back. Put both hands. That looks like a two-handed bastard sword to me. Alright, so, bastard sword because it is of unknown origin, am I right? A bastard sword was named that way because it is made up of things which.
More like it's a bastard between one grip and two grip.
Yeah. Oh, really? Okay. Well, I always thought that it was because its origins of unknown origin. Yeah. Okay, that's good. Thank you very much. This is why I have this man in the class. Alright, so let us. Let us do that first move, all right? So just do that move, slowly, gently, but make it count. No, I want you to do the move, and we're just going to break it down completely. So first move, there, good. All right, so you're going to parry that. So let's just do that. So do the move, there, and then go for it. I would even step further, all right? Okay, so the idea is that you're not just getting the blade out of the way of your body, but you're getting your body out of the way of the blade. All right? You need to put as much distance between yourself and that blade. And that is going to happen with your, with whichever way, you know, you can't just rely on blocking this, blocking it, you know, by technique. You need to get your body out of the way. You need to move that target. You know where that target is, yes? Because he's here in front of you. The only way that you are going to avoid being stabbed is by moving the target. Disorientating where, you know, so she can't keep up with you. And that will be the same when he starts counterattacking. Okay, next person. Who's going first? Thank you very much.
First move.
And. Very good, very good, very good. I think that's a little bit weak. I think you need to put a bit more effort in. I think you need to push into that blade. I think, come. So you come like pushing it out this way. Right, so let's say you just do that move. Okay, so immediately I'm getting out of the way. Even that is a little bit unbalanced. Can you see that? Okay, so you just have to always be aware of what your body is doing. And you have to kind of find the way that you can block, get out of the way, and not fall over. It's amazing how often you will fall over when you're doing a bicep. It's really true. It's really true. You always fall over. This group, please. Okay. And. Very good. So can I see the block now? Ready? And. Okay. Okay, that's good. No, that's okay. Go back. Go back. I want you to do it slow in slow motion. So go, do. And now I'll give you time to figure out how you're going to block it, okay? Ready? And. That's really not doing anything, is it?
It's not.
I would say, if you're going to go here, where are you aiming for? The thigh,
yeah?
Thigh, yeah. Touch my thigh, where you're going to touch it, where you're going to go. Okay, so, do it again. Okay. So, but do it that slowly. So you go. Okay, I blocked it, and just stay there.
You came down.
Yeah, I did this.
You came around.
I did it like cricket. Mm-hmm. Cricket. Okay. So just work on that. Yes, please. Ready and block now. Ready and. Very good. That's great. Do you see this? This is good. This is strong, firm stance. Do that again for me. Very good. I think you need to kind of connect a little bit higher up here. Because I want to see that you know where you're really aiming for. Very good. That's better. That's better. Okay. Go back. See it again. Don't put so much connection into it. Because at the moment we're still working it out, so I need you to be a little bit more fluid. So for example, this is a heavier stick, but if I'm going to come and get you, I'm going to, so block this. See what I mean? Is that she's not having to do too much work. She just needs to concentrate on how to get away from that blade. But do not put too much, otherwise it just makes it harder. Okay, what I'd like to do is I'd like you lot who've been working to take a break and come and sit down along this line and get these guys up. Just make a little space over here. Can you go into the corner? Can you come over here? Just go on this side of the... Is that possible? It doesn't matter. You're okay. It's just that the more space we have here, can you go just sit a little bit more into the corner just so you've got a bit more space? Can you go into the corner and...
Are you okay?
No, you're okay. You're okay, you can go. Who is your partner, by the way?
Very cool. Awesome, at this point.
Great. You lot, can you come here, please? Great. Even a little bit more. Come on. Don't be shy. I'm just trying to give people a bit more space. Okay, so, got a smaller group. We're going to get a bit more involved. All right, so, show me your first stance. Engaged and defense. breathing. Breathe nice and deep. Remember to think about your balance, like a root of a tree. You, my friend, I have a feeling. He's someone you should watch. The root of a tree, strong.
Don't push me.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Strong. Keep your legs firm, 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 strong. Right? Rooted to the ground. Okay? Keep those that elbow in. Keep that elbow in.
Here?
All right? I want you to choose an A and a B in this, in your cup.
Does that mean you, or do you want
you?
Okay.
I'll help you.
And I want the A. Do not look at me. Look at the person you're fighting. They might suddenly sneak a move. All you need to do is listen to me. All right? So, A's, choose a place to attack. Okay, good. Good. Good, very good. Can you go back to the go back to your first stance, please? Stance number one. Ready? Hand. Touch. Ready? Go back. Ready? And touch. Okay. See, not very, very balanced. You need to bring your body. Bring your body with it. Right? Remember, you should not be reaching too much. Okay? Go back. First position. Ready? And. Very good. Very good. Okay. Now, I think you're overreaching. I think you need to get closer. So go back to first position. Hand. Go even closer. Bring it. Bring the pain. All right, come right in here. Okay? You're going to commit. You're going to commit all the way. Right? Fearless. Okay? So, then I want to see a block. So, first of all, first move. Ready? And. Now. I want, now, then wait for it. Now, I want B's to block that move. Very good. Very good. I would say you got great, obviously you've got great upper body strength, but I would say you can go further. So don't just use a sword, push it with the whole body. So bring that body round. Because what you want to do, you want to always remember this. It's something I learned and I almost forgot it when I was doing the first workshop today. Do not just try and get the blade out of the way. Get your body out of the way, because remember, you know where he is. He's there. You want to make sure you disorientate her so she can't find where you are. So once that blade comes out, go. Go, because the next blow can be the surprise one. So you're always, and both of you are going to be searching for that. All right? Do not stand still. If you need to run away, run away. Okay, there's no room to run away, you'll just run into another blade. but, that's the key. Do not just play the blade, make sure you get out of the way. So let us block again. So, go back to the first stance. Ready? And. We're breaking it down. And block. Okay, good. Okay, can we just go back to first stance? Ready? And. Okay. So, what we want to do now is put the two things together. Do not make them so that we cannot see that they're two moves. Because this is the thing about when you choreograph things for film. If it's too fluid, if it looks too easy, invariably the drama gets sucked out of it. You've got to kind of feel that you don't, that the people that are fighting do not know this as choreography. You need to feel like every move is a surprise, that you do not know where it's coming from. So, what I want you to do is put the attack and the block together, but still keep them separate. It's a very, very, very minute detail, but it's the difference between this, come and attack me. Where show me where you're going to attack. Here, okay? It's the difference between, give me a bit of space. It's the difference between and, oh my God, I think I don't know where that's coming. Okay, go. There. So, what I'm trying to do is, because I'm doing it for real, because I don't know where she's going to hit. I'm waiting for the blow before I know how I'm going to defend it. Do you see what I mean?
You sell on the fight.
Yeah, exactly. You've got to sell it. Exactly. So, give it to me again. Yeah, oh my God, yes. So you've got to take a little bit of a risk, but actually it's going to be real because you don't really know what you're doing. Because you don't know what we are. I'm not saying it's because you're rubbish at fighting, I'm saying it's because you don't know what each other is going to give you. So, let us go back to one and put them together. Ready? Wait for it. Ready? And. Okay, if you need to change it, this is good. I want you to stay where you are. I think you need to get more out of the way of that blade, yeah? I think, so did you do the first blow?
Yes.
Yes, and you're blocking it. I think you need to kind of go and just shift your body weight around here, like this is good. So can I see your first move and your block? Okay. You're going into the blade, which is not bad. You can do that. I would suggest, if you're going to do that, you have to disarm her. So, for example, you're going to come, so do the first move, yeah, there, and then I'm going to, down! Oh, okay, good. This is good. You learn about the balance. Oh my God, look at that look on your face.
That's easy.
Woo! All right. Okay, so can we just do that again? So, first move.
I just cut my leg off and hers too.
You see?
Yes.
This is why you need to get out of the way.
Yes.
So do it again, and I want you to get out of the way of that blade. So as you defend it, no, you're going the wrong way.
Oh,
I would say if you're going to push this blade this way, you need to go this
way.
I
need to go that way.
You need to go that way.
Yeah. So you're going to go here. I'm out of here. All right.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And do not anticipate where he's going because you do not know.
Don't know.
Just do it one move at a time.
Okay.
I know what you're like. You're a tiger. You are. Yeah, go get out of the way. Okay, all right, okay. You can see this is a couple. There's a lot of history here. So, can I see your move? Okay, that's good. That's good. You've got the right.
I'm just slightly awkward because I'm left-handed.
Yeah, okay. So here we have an example.
Me too.
Yeah,
here we have an example. Now, I feel like I should confer with my lovely friends. In my experience, and this is what William Hobbs told me, but I do not know if this is true, but I said this morning, that whenever people, whether we're left-handed or right-handed, whenever you're taught to sword fight, you're always taught to sword fight with your right hand. Am I right in saying that?
Historically, in the 15th century, yes, but by the 16th, 17th century, they were like, you have to acknowledge the left-handed opponent
Okay. I heard that he said that people he said, of course, it's probably not a rule, but he said that there were schools of thought. Basically, if you went to train, they would train you with your right hand, whether you could do it with your left or your right. But this is why I think it was it's not true. But I'm sure there were a lot of people who would use their left hand to their advantage because everything is different. And I think there is also something when in Game of Thrones that when Arya fights with her left hand, that is something that Syrio notices and goes, that's good, because it will keep your opponent off balance. Because they can't play to your weak side. You're not defending it. You're defending it a completely different way. You're almost showing them your back all the time. the vulnerable bits are not your, and it's because it's easier for you to fight like this, and yet it's harder for them to attack the soft fleshy bits. I'm sure that's one of the reasons. So, can I see your left hand?
Okay.
No, 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 questions.
No questions.
No questions. Okay, here I am. Here I am. I'm about to fight. Okay? First thing you want to do is check out your opponent. Okay? Yeah? You're going to let me just stab you? Yes, you are. You're going to move. If you see what I'm doing, this is the thing. It doesn't just begin with one move. You're going to start to negotiate. So you're going to go, okay, so we're standing side to side like this. You're pretty much guarded completely. I need to come this way. Yeah, exactly. Or I'm going to go this way, or I'm going to come and catch. Yeah, you see? Now we start to fight, right? We're negotiating. So that's what you need to do. So this is asking you to use your imagination a little bit. Right, I'd like you to take a break, go over there. Thank you very much. Give them a round of applause.
Awesome.
Ask two people at a time to come in here. We're going to work out a little something sexy. Yes. Can I have two volunteers? Yeah, no, come. First come. Of course, I'm going to have to get through this pretty quickly, all right? So, let us begin. First stance. And... very good. Okay. Ready? And. See, I think you are that strong, but I think you're reaching for the block. I think you're not going to really block that. So can you just do it again? I need you to come. So what's your first move? Here. See, I think you need to block and move. You're trying to do two things at the same time. So you need to break it down a little bit more. So you get the first move, go. Yeah. It doesn't matter. You do the first move. So you need to block it, get out of the way. See, you're not really getting out of the way, you're just moving back away from the blade. And this blade is gonna go all over the place. You don't think this blade is like, oh my god, this is not helping, right? This is what it's like. So Play with me. You're going to do the first move. Okay. So I'm just going to try and get out of the way. Just come towards me. First move. Ah. Okay. All right. So what we need to do? We need to block and get out of the way. That's the most important thing. So. You need to get away from that blade. You're kind of still wanting to get engaged with it, which is not right. So let's just try it. I think you just need to move more. Away from the blade. Wherever you're putting that blade, you need to get away from it in the opposite direction. So, first move, and. Okay, this is good. What I want you to do now is to break it down. This is gonna be choreography. So, let us do it. Do it with me like a dance. So, no effort. These are going to touch, but we're going to act the effort, right? So, you do the first move. Yeah, and I'm moving, okay? So, and then I'm going to come again. I'm going to come for you here, okay? No contact, it's too much energy, all right? This is a dance, okay? Gentle, like fluid. Yes. Okay, so I want you to kind of engage with each other, but almost like give it some space. Okay, so what you're doing is that, just, so let's, that, I'm going to give you a move, right? So here we are. You've got your sword. Come for that. Right, so you're going to block it. You need to engage in this block, right? You've got to step into it, because if you do not step into it, this blade is going to come and just catch your face. So just do it again for me. batch it here, okay? You've got to go. So what you're doing is you're letting that go. You've got to keep strong. It's because you've got very weak wrists. You've got to keep them strong. Because that's where you're going to get in all of this business. And that's not good because both of you are just going to have your eyes covered. So you've got to keep strong. That's why you've got to keep those elbows in. So these things are like, you've got to think about it. Let's do it without the swords. You're going to do it with your hands. Right? Here is my blade. So I want you to come. And there. Good.
And then we usually do
with... No, don't worry about it. We're going to do it with hands because it's going to give you an idea of the amount of effort you need. So come to me. There. Here. All right? Already he's dead. Okay? So let's just do that. Keep that arm strong. So he's going to come for you. Out. There, very good, you see? But you need to not be too, because this is okay, you're not gonna hurt, is it? Right? So come to me again. There. Good. And also remember to get out of the way. For example, if he's gonna come for you like this, you can come here. You can get right down low. You can use your height. Okay, so all of these things are very important. Take a seat, give him a round of applause. Now, no, this gives you much more, and also the reason why I'm doing it like this is very different to the way that like a teacher like we have here was going to teach you. He's going to give you technique and skill. I'm looking at what the organic essence is of sword fighting. The fact that in reality, if you carried a sword around and someone challenged you to a duel, you are not going to get elaborate and you're not going to start showing off. Because there's no time for that. You also have to remember that people had reputations as great fighters. Invariably, their reputation would go before them. So they wouldn't even get engaged in fights because people would see them and go, yeah, there's no way. If that man's challenged you, you just leave town. Just leave. Do not get engaged. It's only the crazy ones who would go. And in fact, most of those people had that reputation and they never even used to fight. You should just kind of turn up and go, yeah, okay. And that would be enough. That would intimidate me. It's like a game of poker. So a lot of this is just about how two people respond. It's about chemistry, all right? It doesn't matter how big he is, how small you are, how experienced, how inexperienced, because circumstances change, the terrain changes. Sometimes the sun is in your eyes. Sometimes you're fighting someone and you're going up a hill. Everything changes. It's like football, it's like soccer. You can have two great teams, you never know whether one's going to win and one's going to lose. It's completely random. So, first position. And, very good, very good, very good. Back hit. Okay, so now let's break it down. Do not do it too quickly. So let's have the first move. There, and counter attack. Good, good, good. So let's just carry on. Let's have the first move, the counter, the block, and the counter attack, and then the counter attack again. So break it down. First move, and go. Good, very good, very good, very good. Now it's got a little bit of the martial art about it, yes? Yeah? Good. Let's see it a little bit more, because you're quite good at this. And just break it down. That's it. Good. That's it. Yeah, yeah.